What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to The World According to Briggs, a channel that tries to give you some information about places to live. Today we're talking about the most moved to state in the country, Texas, and its second most popular city, Houston. Houston is right here, in case you don't know, not too far from the Gulf of Mexico. It is home to over 2.1 million residents, making it the fourth largest city by population in the U.S., with the metro area having just under 7 million, making that the fifth largest metro area. Now, I feel like I should explain metro areas. We've had a couple people leave comments about they don't understand metro areas, why do I keep bringing it up, and normally I just let it go, but people seem to be jumping down their throat, so I'll give you an explanation. A metro area is just the city plus all its suburbs. It's simple. It almost never comes up unless you're talking about a major city, and it's kind of gives you an idea of how crowded they are. It's easy. It's not a big deal. Houston is a great city with rich history, and it's in what I refer to as Hurricane Alley. That's the Gulf Coast between New Orleans and Brownsville, Texas. For some reason, it seems to be a funnel for hurricanes. Every single year, they're in danger of getting a hurricane. Other than Florida, that feels like it's, to me, the most common thing you hear. But like all cities, Houston has its problems. One is dangerous neighborhoods. They have some real gems here. Not the worst in the country, but it really seems like they're putting in the effort to get there. So, if you're thinking about moving to Houston, which it has jobs and people are moving there, these are the 10 neighborhoods you should avoid because they're dangerous. Number 10, downtown Houston. The downtown Houston neighborhood is the largest business district in Houston, Texas. It's located at the geographic center of the metro area, so it's like right in the middle. It's also where Interstate 10, Interstate 45, and Interstate 69 meet. This area is a problem because of the high number of people moving in and out of here on a daily basis. Is it your typical dangerous neighborhood? No, not really. It's not like gangs and things like that. It has tourists and about 150,000 office employees moving around this area, so, you know, there's a lot of opportunity to have some problems. Assaults are frequent and road rage is not uncommon. The national average for violent crime is about 2,500 for every 100,000 residents. The downtown Houston area sees a little over 3,300 for every 100,000. The violent crime rate here is 78% higher than the national average. Number 9, Bel Air. So, this one caught me off guard. I had no idea. I've been to this part of Houston. I have a cousin that lives there currently. I thought it was a decent place, but according to the FBI's website, they get some violence. Bel Air is a residential area just west of downtown, and it's not too far from the Houston Zoo, which I've been to that zoo. I liked it. It was a really hot day, and when I went there, I noticed they had a lot of wood pathways in different areas, which made it a lot easier on the feet. Hot cement for 4 or 5 hours is a rough day. Any of you parents out there already know this. Bel Air is a decent town that, like I said, gets some violence. Their overall crime rate isn't terrible, but the violent type, it gets up there. The violent crime rate is 83% higher than the national average in Bel Air. Number 8, West Chase. West Chase is a business district and neighborhood in western Houston. This is another one that isn't a terrible neighborhood, it just has some bad stats. The poverty level and unemployment are about equal to the national average, and their overall crime isn't crazy. They just get into hurting each other here, I guess. In the 1950s, large portions of West Chase were purchased by Robert E. Smith, a Houston oil businessman, who was the owner of the Houston Colt 45s back in the day. It's a baseball team that later changed their name to the Astros. He bought the land and started developing it. One thing led to another, and the Astros cheated to win the World Series. West Chase's biggest problem is apartment buildings. They have a bunch. And when you have too many people living on top of each other, it can get bad. And this is a perfect example. Their violent crime rate is 89% higher than the national average. Number 7. East End. East End is a neighborhood bounded on the west by downtown Houston and on the east by the Port of Houston. They have the wonderfully polluted Buffalo Bayou on the east side of the neighborhood, and it flows past the site of Harrisburg, which was an early Texas trading post in the Republic of Texas days. That was like 1936. Seriously, though, never go in the water here. They have a canoe launch and different things like that, but this water is just so polluted. You'll have a tumor growing by the time you dry off. They do have great tacos and a good amount of violent crime here. Up in the Second Ward neighborhood, which is part of East End, you have the Clayton Homes housing project, which adds to the violence of the overall neighborhood. The violent crime rate here is 91% higher than the national average. Yeah, it's not really a place you need to visit. Unless, of course, you're really jonesing for some quality tacos. They do have them here. Nifa's on Navigation that's one of the best taco places I've ever eaten at. Number 6, Northwest. Next, we have the neighborhood of Northwest. Not a lot of thought went into naming this neighborhood, I guess, because it's northwest of downtown Houston. I wonder if the search for a name was intense. Did they have like brainstorming sessions and group talks about it? Charts and graphs and an easel? Probably not. Northwest has the neighborhoods of Spring Branch in there and Northwest Crossing. All these neighborhoods are within Northwest. This is one of those places some locals may just call it Spring Branch or something like that, but I think a majority call it Northwest. Northwest has some crime and a nice nature area called Bear Creek Pioneer Park with some really nice hiking trails. It's kind of nice, but yeah, you don't want to be there at night alone. Not sure how much violent crime goes on in the park, but the rest of the neighborhood is pretty thick with it. Northwest's violent crime rate is 128% higher than the national average. Northwest is only safer than 10% of the neighborhoods in Texas. Like, the entire state, there's only 10% of them that are more dangerous. That's pretty scary. Number 5, the Astrodome Area Super Neighborhood. Now that's what it's technically called, the Astrodome Area Super Neighborhood. It's a neighborhood in Houston that also has the neighborhood of Medical. Yeah, they call that one Medical. I don't know where they get all these names, but that one sort of makes sense. Because this neighborhood has the Texas Christian Hospital, Baylor School of Medicine, the Houston Methodist Hospital, and a bunch of other ones. They also have a whole bunch of violent crime. There's about 20,000 people that live here, and it can get dangerous. The violent crime rate here is 130% higher than the national average, and this is another one of those cases where it has a lot to do with how many people live in apartment buildings here. Like I was saying before, when you get too many people in a small area, bad stuff starts happening. You also, if you look at the stats here, not a lot of the people here have really good jobs. A lot of people are on a budget, and that tends to, you know, heighten problems in the area. You have about a 1 in 19 chance of being the victim of a crime in the Astrodome Area Super Neighborhood. Yeah, pretty high. Number 4, South Park. South Park is a broad post-World War II development in South Central area of Houston. This neighborhood ain't great. It actually sucks. One guy said this is a great place to be robbed of your groceries in a grocery store parking lot. They might not even take your money, just your groceries. That's what the guy said. South Park is within the Southeast neighborhood, which has its own set of issues. They're just, now you got South Park with Southeast all around it with, you know, making it even better. Just kidding. Totally makes it worse. The unemployment rate normally stays around 40% higher than the national average in South Park, and the violent crime is where these people excel. They're doing phenomenal if you want to be a very violent neighborhood. Their violent crime rate is 152% higher than the national average. Like I said, this place ain't great. It actually sucks. Number 3, North Houston. North Houston is a small neighborhood in what I'm sure you've already guessed, in the northern part of Houston. It's near the Sam Houston horse racing track, and this place is like a poor neighborhood in a third world country, which happens to be inside a first world country. I read a review of this neighborhood by a guy that described it like a little patch of heaven. It was such a flowery review, I began to think the government website that I got the crime stats from was way off, like they made a mistake. Nah, I checked it out. It wasn't. The dude was way off. He needs his medication checked or quit wearing like one of those virtual reality headsets 18 hours a day. The average income in North Houston is 56% lower than the national average, but that's nothing compared to the violent crime rate, which is 170% higher than the national average. It is a rough place to live. Number 2, Northeast Houston. Okay, now we're getting ugly. We're starting to get into those Chicago and Detroit style bad neighborhoods. You know, the really bad ones where if the police see you driving in there, they'll turn you around, like tell you, you don't need to go to this neighborhood. This is one of those. Northeast Houston is a large neighborhood with industrial sections, chemical plants, petroleum plants, and bars on almost all the windows in all the residential areas. When 9 out of 10 homes on a block have bars on the windows, you need to forget this place exists. Just move to someplace else. Don't drive in here. Don't drive by here. This is one of those places. Northeast is a place you should really forget. All forms of crime are sky high in this neighborhood, with violent crimes being so high, I consider it unsuitable for human life forms. Yeah, it's that bad. The crime rate here is 200% higher than the national average. Yeah, 200%. If you don't get assaulted or worse, your stuff's going to be taken at some point. There's no reason to live here. And number 1, Far North. Far North is a little hard to pinpoint where its borders actually are, but it's north of Aldine and east of the George Bush Airport. Like almost anywhere in the country, neighborhoods near a giant airport suck. They just do. There's too much stuff going on around there. There's too much opportunity for criminals, so the crime rate's always high. Far North is no different. Industrial areas, apartment buildings, trailer parks, and a giant airport all drive up the crime rate in Far North. The only thing that's a good stat here is the cost of living. It is dirt cheap to live in this area. And that's because nobody wants to live there. It's just how it goes, you know? If the place sucks, housing and cost of living is going to be cheap. So if you're looking to save a buck and you don't mind risking your own life to, I don't know, check your mail, go to work, hang out in your backyard, Far North may be a great place for you. All their stats are high when it comes to crime, but their violent crime rate is 250% higher than the national average. Yeah, that's really high. Far North is the most dangerous place to live in Houston. All right, that's our video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you got some information out of it. Now you know where not to live in Houston. If you're looking to move to Houston, there's a lot of good places. The ones on this list are ones you should not consider, unless it's by like court order or something like that. All right, don't forget all the links below. Give the video a big thumbs up. Leave a comment. Tell me what you thought. Don't forget to subscribe. Everybody have a great day. Be nice to each other.